The Philippine President signs a bill forming the Negros Island region. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. enacted one of his pet measures Thursday to incorporate the Negros provinces, Siquijor and Central Philippines, into one administrative region. Now, Marcos in his speech says the move will position Negros as a hub for development in the Visayas. He also believes this will improve locals' access to government services and address uneven growth.
For decades now, Negrenses have endured the rigors of sea travel, unnecessary expenses, bureaucratic red tape, inefficiency that this arrangement has brought, especially when there is a need to urgently access government services from regional centers. The new Negros Island region will be a bulwark of greater growth, as well as a conduit for more effective and efficient delivery of essential services in the region. We envision as well the NIR as one of the centers of development in the Visayas, further accelerating socio-economic development for the millions of Negrenses and providing strategic convergence.
Also signed into law as a measure to improve the country's real property valuation and assets assessment system.
This new law is born out of the necessity and the realization that there is a need to enhance the country's tax collection system so we can generate revenues, generate jobs, investments all over the country. No longer will we rely on the outdated valuation system.
The total assets of Philippine banks climbed in April, buoyed by growth in loans. Preliminary data from the Philippine Central Bank show local lenders' total assets were 25.49 trillion pesos as of the end of April. That figure is 12% higher than what was recorded a year ago. Month on month, however, it is lower by 0.7%. Bank's total loan portfolio, meanwhile, stood at 13.46 trillion pesos. That's 1.8% higher month-on-month and 11% higher year-on-year. The Philippine Supreme Court orders the reopening of graft cases involving real estate firm Delta Ventures Resources of the late tycoon Roberto Ongpin. The cases stem from the granting of 660 million pesos in loans in 2009 by the Development Bank of the Philippines to Delta Ventures. The court said that dismissal of the cases by the Sandigan Bayan was improper because the standard of clear lack of probable cause was not observed. In the cases filed before the Sandigan Bayan, the ombudsman alleged then DBP officials took advantage of their positions and conspired with Delta Ventures for the loan. Transport Chief Jaime Bautista leads the groundbreaking of the Calamba Depot of the South Commuter Railway Project. Andrea Taguines joins us with details. Andy, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Denise. The Department of Transportation sees the North to South Commuter Railway beginning partial operations in 2027. That's 1 year later than initially stated. The northern line of the NSTR, which would run from Clark, Pampanga to Valenzuela City in Metro Manila, will be the first to go online. That's according to DOTR Secretary Jaime Bautista at the sidelines of the groundbreaking ceremony for the Banlik Calamba Depot on Thursday. Bautista and Philippine National Railways Chairman Michael Macapagal earlier said that this portion of the train line could be done as early as 2026. Meanwhile, the Manila to Calamba Laguna segment of the project is expected to be operable by 2029. The entire NSTR project, which consists of 35 stations, was initially eyed to be completed and fully operational by 2028. The delay comes as the DOTR continues to face challenges in terms of right-of-way acquisition. Bautista said this is precisely why the government created an interagency task force that would focus on resolving right-of-way issues concerning railway projects. The relocation of families affected by the project is also underway. The NSTR is a 147-kilometer mass transit system that is planned to connect Clark, Pampanga to Calamba, Laguna. It is expected to service up to 800,000 passengers daily and cut travel time from Clark Airport to Calamba, Laguna to less than 2 hours from the current 4 hours. Bautista hopes that in the coming years, with the completion of the NSTR and other big-time railway projects, such as the Metro Manila Subway and the MRT Line 7, mobility and the traffic situation in the National Capital Region and nearby provinces will greatly improve. Denise?
Andrea Taguines with that story. Thanks, Andy.